So what is the Philippine Retailers Association? This is the group that I represent. I'm the president of this recognized trade organization in the country, wherein we have retailers and suppliers. And our main objective is really to help the retailers develop and grow, no? And at the same time, if the CEO Summit's goal is to make the Philippines a first world country, our goal is very simple: to make the Philippine retailers, or the retailers who are our members, globally competitive, to help them to be globally competitive. And of course, we are the drivers also of the economy, as I've mentioned earlier. So for the last 40 years, what we do is we organize or provide significant programs and initiatives such as study missions, business missions abroad, international. The PRA has also been in the forefront of major issues. So we help our retailers, you know, if there's any issue or any major concerns that will impact the retailer, we're very much active and involved, no? So as an organization, basically, we are the stewards, no? So we help our retailers, our retailer members in all aspects of their business. So what is the state now of the online shopping in Asia? Consumers now are increasingly turning into e-commerce. And of course, there are a lot of expectations surrounding us, no, when it comes to fulfillment and experience. Many millennials are digital natives. So they're really very engaged, no? They're always on in the net, no? And then some of them, they have entered the workplace already. So they have high disposable income, and then they're very time strapped. So they really like to shop online, no? And then for the Gen Z, shopping may be more than just simply buying stuff, no? So what they want is really to, you know, to bond with friends. What is the state of online shopping in Asia? Half of the Asian consumers find lower prices to be very, very, you know, to be the driving force. No? It entices them to buy online because they look for great deals. They have more choices than what the physical store can offer. Aside from giving you the convenience, aside from giving you the vast number of choices, I guess it's really more of, you know, that comfortable and that comfortable, you know, experience that it gives, you know. And it also says here that 54% of the Gen Z shoppers say that high shopping costs, I think this is the concern of most of the Gen Z, you know. They're concerned about the high shopping cost. I guess because Gen Z, they say they're more practical. They're always looking for value for money. Still, online is not really very, I mean, in terms of the revenue that we get from online shopping, it's not really very significant. It's only about 2% of the total retail revenue, no? So it's only about 2%, which is about 10 million customers every day. So it's not really very significant. Still, I think Filipinos still prefer to go to the physical store. They love going to the malls. They love, you know, engaging with the promodizers. We call them promodizers. They love to inquire with the promodizers rather than doing it themselves. Shopping is limitless. It's just really, you know, connecting, giving that strong, and I'm offering that strong connection with the customer. No? For those who want to, you know, who want to go into business or want to go to online, we have a study here that for e-commerce, the number one, I think among the segments, no, or among the sectors, the number one really is travel and accommodation. Next would be electronics and physical for those interested to go into online retailing. Next would be fashion and beauty, and of course, furniture and appliance. You don't see home improvement yet. And what's interesting is we just launched our shop.wilcon.com.ph last January only. However, I would still say that it's not even a fraction of our total revenue. Okay, so we see a lot of visits, and we realize that, you know, consumers, those who are building, those who are renovating, refining their homes, they still want that sense of, you know, touch. They still want that sense of look and feel of the products. So they still want to visit the store. So using that platform, I'm sure you're familiar with the word BOPIS. Gutom na kayo, magla-lunch na. BOPIS, you browse online and you pick it in store. So that's how our, you know, online shop works for Wilcon. We do BOPIS, okay? Kasi millennials daw bobo, buy online, browse online, or browse online, buy online. So we offer it only in Metro Manila, Rizal, and Cavite. No offense meant, that's only a joke. And then mode of payment would be through credit card. Through credit card, okay? So, what is the future of retail? Okay, the apocalypse daw is, you know, a lot of stores are closing down, no? I would say the future of retail is whether, if you want to survive, you either adapt or you either, you know, because a lot of people are thinking that, you know, online is a distraction. It's antagonistic, right? So I guess moving forward, the most important is whether you're in physical, whether you're in the cloud, or whether you're offline or online, the most important is you have to know your customer first. You have to connect. You have to have that strong connection with your customers before you introduce innovations, because there's a lot of innovations. There's a lot of information, you know. The digital world can offer you all this information, all this data. However, it's using that data to your benefit. Will it be cost efficient to your business? Will it benefit? Are you talking rightly to your market? Okay. So, moving forward, it's very important that you know your customer and you anticipate what they need. And of course, experience is everything. Do you know that the new currency now is customer experience and excellent customer service? That's the new currency now. Because, you know, shopping online, shopping offline, it's limitless. You see this large format, you see all these big bags around us, no? I mean, but then it's really the experience that you give your customer, the connection or that moment of truth that you offer to your customer. So experience is really everything.